Dear students, in previous case we considered a single charge that was moving across magnetic force. Does the force acting on that depend on V cross B into Q, single charge? So that was a system of in which we considered single charge. But what happens in real, whenever we have a real situation, in that situation we have conductors and a charge is flowing across the conductor with velocity v. So in that case we always consider linear charge density. So if the length of the conductor is L, so we know that current is equal to Q over T. And here we will not consider this single charge because charge is continuous across this whole segment. So now we will consider another quantity, that is lambda. Lambda is equal to charge multiplied by divided by length of the conductor. So linear charge density is charge per unit length. So if we want to calculate now charge, what is the total charge on this whole conductor, then we can calculate Q is equal to lambda into length of the wire. So now we can put I is a lambda into L divided by T, and we know that L length per unit time is equal to velocity. So lambda into V. So current is equal to now linear charge density moving with velocity V. So if we want to consider the force on whole this wire acting whenever it is placed inside magnetic field. When we place this wire inside magnetic field, magnetic force acts on this because current charges are flowing per unit time across this wire. So now we will consider their total force acting on this whole wire. So we know that if we have single charge, then the force acting on that single charge is equal to small force, df means small force, that is equal to V cross B into dq. dq is a small charge, but we have large number of charges across this segment, so all charges will feel force. So we will sum all this force, we will sum all this force. So now we will take integration of this whole expression so that we can find total force on this whole wire. So df will be total force F, and this will be V cross B into dq. And if we consider dq is a continuous charge, is continuous across the line segment, so we will take here lambda into dl. dl is a small segment of the wire, so we will integrate over the total wire so that we can find the total force on this wire. So that will be equal to V, if we place lambda here, into B into dl. So this will become, because V into lambda is equal to I cross B into dl. So current and length are in same direction, so we can write here dl cross B into I. So that is a same thing, dl and I flow in the same direction. Or we can also write I is out of integral. So this will become dl cross B. Yeah. So this is the formula for finding the force, total force on a wire when it is placed inside magnetic field. So consider a case, we have an example, we'll solve that from above. So that example is a rectangular loop of wire supporting a mass hangs vertically with one end in a uniform magnetic field B, which points into the page in the shaded region of the figure 5.10. For what current I in the loop would the magnetic force upward exactly balance the gravitational force downward? So we have a case like this. We have a rectangular loop and its half end, this is inside a magnetic field, and the magnetic field is into the page. So magnetic field is into the page. So we will represent with crosses. So half of the loop is into the magnetic field, and it has also mass. So mass, gravitational force will be downward, and current is flowing in clockwise direction like this. So it will have also magnetic force. So current is flowing in this direction, clockwise direction, and weight force is in this direction. Both are in opposite direction, because how we will find the magnetic force direction? So straight your fingers in direction of the current flow, and rotate in direction of magnetic field. So your thumb will point out in direction of magnetic force. So magnetic force will be in upward direction. So magnetic force will be in this direction, and the weight will be in this direction. So if it has length A, this side is length A, and the forces on this segment and this vertical segment will be equal to zero. Okay, so the force, magnetic force on this line segment will be upward, because current is flowing in this direction, and if rotate into the page in towards the magnetic field, so extended thumb will point the direction of the force. So we have to calculate how much current we have to flow so that both forces are equal. So we know that if magnetic must be equal to F gravitational, so that this coil must remain balanced, must not fall towards the earth. So this F magnetic force, we know that its magnitude is I L B, and F gravitational, we know that its magnitude is M into G. So if we want to find the magnitude of the current, so if we here place I, and L is length of the conductor is A, into B is equal to mg. So I can be written as mg over A into B. So that is the current that flows that across the conductor, so that it can be in equilibrium. So what happens if we increase the magnitude of the current? If we increase the magnitude of the current across the coil, so magnetic force will increase. Magnetic force will increase. Okay. As a result, the coil will be moved up in the up direction. And if we decrease the current, so the weight will overcome and the coil will move downward. So in that case, work done, absolutely yes. So because The block was moving upward. The loop was moving upward. So here work is done. Absolutely work is done. But previously we have considered magnetic forces to no work. So here, which force is doing work? So the work is done by the battery here. Battery is doing work. So magnetic force is only directing the charges, because the loop is moving upward in up direction and a current is moving in horizontal direction. So magnetic force has a component, a force that is pushing charges upward. So magnetic force is only redirecting the horizontal force of the battery into the vertical motion of the loop and a weight. So similar analogy you can take in whenever we have a block on a horizontal